Now, this project embodies the state government's commitment to promote cultural stewardship and a bottom-up approach in heritage. It is without doubt that the long-term conservation of the Georgetown World Heritage Site is dependent upon our future generations. Fostering these future stewards of our cultural resources is critical in the long-term sustainability of Penang's heritage, especially imbuing within them the idea that doing less is actually more. And only when they support and they buy in the significance and importance to preserve heritage, then only can heritage be sustained. If only we are concerned about heritage and not our younger children, then heritage has no future. We are wasting not only our money, but wasting our time here. I may as well ask Professor Dato' Mokhtar Saidin, balik saja kita tidur lah. Lagi baik. Kita semua tidur. So, we have actually put in a lot of money. We have employed Professor Dr. Mokhtar Saidin as a chief archaeologist at the Guakapur site. We have put in money all because we want to preserve it. Now, if the younger generation does not support that, then we are wasting money. We should probably cancel the program. So that's why, whilst we are, of course, investing in these programs, we must also invest in inculcating amongst our young an awareness and as well as a love of heritage, for heritage. Now, under this magnet initiative, we hope to mobilize the young to love heritage. Now, GDCDC has one of the prime movers of the magnet initiative, is also working on a new museographic concept for the Penang State Museum. For the Penang State Museum building at Pakua Street, a community archives program and the conservation of the site Al-Atas mentioned. Now all these initiatives aim to enhance the physical cultural facilities, the residual intelligence and experience, as well as provide opportunities for commercial or community involvement. Penang itself is indeed rich in archaeological heritage. As I mentioned about the Guakapur site, we've got a 5,600-year-old woman discovered, the skeleton discovered. So we say this is Penang woman. And according to our chief archaeologist, Professor Dr. Mokhtar Saidin, he says that there is hope to find some more, because they have discovered a very large mound, shell median, they call it, shell median. If I want to use some archaeological words. He has found a large shell median, a large mound of shells, huge shells. And underneath, he suspects very likely that there are more skeletons buried under. We do not know how old they are, but at least we should be around 5,700 years old. We look forward to promoting public archaeology into a statewide initiative and invite the local community to play an active part in the interpretation and preservation of cultural heritage. Now, this young archaeologist program is part of the ongoing excavation to uncover the moat structure that originally surrounded the fort. So we are not asking our young archaeologists go to the Guakapur site, no. That one is for seniors first lah. These are juniors, we talk about rediscovering the moat structure, because this fort used to be surrounded by a moat filled with water. So we are thinking, why don't we restore the moat as recommended by the Fort Cornwallis Conservation Management Plan. Restore Fort Cornwallis to its original setting, a period of the highest significance, so that you will see the moat filled with water, what it was 200 years ago. And at that time, you know, they had that moat so that enemies, you know, will not be so easy for them to go and climb up the walls. Of course, fortunately, as Dr. Anwar Fazal said, the fort was never used. It was more a danger to the city it was trying to protect than to its enemies. If it had been used, I think that not only would the fort collapse, maybe the probably the explosion would have shaken all other buildings down. And in a way, I think it was a very important symbol of the strength of the defenses of Penang. But like they say, it's more like a paper tiger. But despite that, I think paper tiger has its uses. Because it shows that indeed Penang was a tiger in the 19th century. One bigger even than Singapore, before Singapore overtook us. So I think this is a very timely reminder of the importance, of the important role played by Penang Port 200 years back. So in order to restore that moat structure, the conservation work is set to begin next month, September. So apart from restoring the authenticity of Port Cornwallis, the reinstatement of the moat feeds into a larger effort to revitalize cultural spaces and facilities in the North Seafront of Georgetown. GTCDC is also conducting upgrading works to the seawall and landscape upgrading of the North Seafront, an area that makes up approximately 85% of all public open spaces in the Georgetown World Heritage Site. So work is beginning to change the face of Georgetown. The face where we first presented ourselves to the world through the waters. And I think it is a very exciting period. You may not see it now, but when it's completed, you will know why I would say it's a very exciting period. For archaeologists, it is doubly exciting. Not only are we doing something here, the existing one, but now you're discovering new ones. So Penang is now the center for archaeology, expedition and knowledge in Malaysia. I think that passion that we share because of our love for heritage, that it makes Penang better. People say, you love heritage, waste time, waste money. Why is the CM focusing on this, not focusing on other issues? I say, no, because when you love heritage, you make Penang better. You love culture, you love art, you also make Penang stronger and better because it allows us to reach within us and touch our spiritual soul, reach our roots so that we know we are part of the larger humanity, the larger mosaic of humanity. And it's very important to know that we are just not one piece. We are part of the larger mosaic. Different types, different colors, different textures, but we are all part of humanity. I think this is very important so that we can, when we reach within ourselves, somehow we are all similar and it allows us to connect with each other. So we hope that this program is a beginning, and that's why we are open. We're not limited only to students from Penang. We are open to our neighboring streets from Kedah also. Because as I said just now, because we are all part of humanity, we will not be bound by our borders. We consider this as a project for all Malaysians.
It was actually building on top just a layer of stone, okay. That you just lay like that, not sealing. So you can still drawing up the stone.
So this was added on by our local water authority?
No, this is...
No, this one, the pipes here.
Yeah, this is part of the...
New thing.
Yeah, it's all
UVA. PVA. You just keep it there.
Yeah, we just leave it there. That's what we do.